Yeah.
So what's on today's agenda, boy?
I want to take off the chrome bumpers, put the plastic ones on.
Is this on the?
On the, say the Jetta Mark 1. And just do an introduction on the car. What's the car about? What's in the car? And yeah, that's basically it.
Okay, so we're going to a secret hideout to go work on a secret project.
Not so secret.
Not so secret, but secret as well. Yeah, most people know we're from Strand. So we're ripping the CUI.
Ripping CUI.
So yeah, stay tuned. Wesley Gordon with his wonderful Jetta / Fox build, but let me not talk too much about his car. He's gonna walk us through it, introducing his car to us in the YouTube form. Yeah. So yeah, can you tell us what's done to the car, what is the car, what the future plans of the car is, and what can we expect from you in this build?
Yeah, so firstly, as you can see, it's a Jetta Mark 1. It's been converted to a Jetta Mark 1. It was a Fox and it was red. I made it red at first and then I got bored of the look and I decided to go old school.
Okay, so you're a color swapper. You like to play with colors on cars.
And I had a white original Jetta Mark 1 before this. So I like the look of it, man. I like the old school look. So I got the front panel, the fenders, everything. Actually got it very quick, but some people say you don't find these parts, but luckily people.
we've been searching all the gravy, Mark 1 gravy was in Cape Town for parts,
For parts. So this is the car. Can show you the motor.
Yeah. I think everyone is waiting for that part.
It's a VVL motor, it's sort of 20 VE, running on a Golf gearbox.
Don't mind the starter modification, the ear broke off, so I just did a modification just to get the car to start. But yeah, the car has
been driving and it's standing for probably a year now again because of this whole thing. Take my time with stuff, get out the scars.
So I don't know if you guys are missing a intake here.
Yeah.
I don't know if Wes wants to elaborate on that part, but I think he has something special on that regard. I don't know if he wants to share that as of yet.
Yeah. I'm busy building a custom intake for the car. So I'll get it probably in this coming week from the engineers. So it's a Honda intake that I'm running on a VVL, and it's a K-tuned Honda throttle body that I'm running on a VVL.
So it's a mixed emotion car.
This car is mixed. I have VTEC seats in the car, front seats. I have VR6 rims on. I need tires.
Anyone that got a pair of nice 15 inch for this guy, just let us know. Anything else special that you want to share on the car?
The motor, there's no major work done to the motor. I'm running the Golf gearbox with a spool diff, 4.25 ratio final drive, and then I'm running Golf flywheel, Golf clutch. I'm running Navara coil packs, RBT bolt the motor for me, race brake tuning. I'm running a DE crank that was knife edged. it's been balanced by Warren from Stealth Engineering. I did head work by the headmaster, I'm running stock cams and a light head scheme, that's about it, and I'm running the car on fuel, so it's nothing special, and I have nitros on the car also.
Just calmly stating that part.
This is the nozzle and these the solenoids. So yeah, everything's connected. I must just put the car together and go tune again and hopefully get my goal power mark that I want.
What do you expect out of this build? On a serious note.
If I do cams, Jason from RBT told me not to do cams now. But I don't want N1 cams. I want bigger cams than N1. So if I do cams and I'm running 100 shot of nitros, which is about 75 kilowatt. So I'll probably, I don't want to say something.
Just a ballpark.
And then, okay, probably 240 kilowatt.
Okay, so that's a solid figure.
240 kilowatt.
That he's really been pushing for. And tell me, are you running standard exhaust, any custom branch intakes, anything like that?
Running noise voice. Exhaust and branch, which RBT also designed. I think Noise Boy sells the RBT branch. I think it's 48 more, 45 more, 63 more, two boxes. But I'm gonna do the exhaust over because nothing wrong with Noise Boys, but I just feel like I should do it over because I just feel so.
Okay, guys, so this is just a quick introduction of this little fun car. We just felt the need to do this as it is something that has been coming along for a few years that we've been putting some effort in. Wesley has been putting in so much time into this car, effort and, yeah, most important, money. You can't build cars like this without a little bit of money. And yeah, we've been hustling for him and getting parts where we can. This is a little bit of the interior. The detail isn't all there as of yet, but I think that will come at the later stage. This is the VTEC seats that was converted into Ricardo's. So basically it's a dream build that is taking a bit of time, but I feel like he will get there and the support is all there. We're all pushing for this and it will be a beast when it's done.
And the plans totally changed for the car. This was supposed to be my race car. Like, you know how I was full on, I'm gonna board a race car and stuff. And as I was boarding it, I was just thinking, man, no, man. Why board a race car that you only use for a season and then the car stands? Board a nice, fun car where you can go on a liquor drive with the guys, you can do breakfast runs, you can do everything, you have a bit of power, your car looks way, you see?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Okay. So that in a nutshell, guys. Here is a few goodies lying around, but like Wesley mentioned, we will do this in a follow-up video. We won't compile everything into one. This was just to introduce the car. And yeah, if you like the content and you're excited to see the progression on this, the few months coming, I think, will be a lot of finishing touches that's going to be put on the car. And yeah.
And yeah, this isn't the only car we're building. We have your car. I have my Honda that I want to turbo in the near future or in a few months or whenever is ready. So the content will be.
Yeah, we got a few stuff lined up and we are sourcing parts. I myself am not where I want to be with my cars as of yet, but we're slowly virtually building towards something. Mr. Kayla in Kraaifontein, I must give him a shout out.
Yeah.
He's been talking some sense into some of us.
Yeah.
So
he and his dad actually bought my gearbox because I broke four golf gearboxes already and I'm running they call it a Nicky Kyler. I'm running a Nicky Kyler.
A spicy setup.
And this box, I did Saldana one event with the car when it was red. And since then, the box is still keeping.
Yeah, I don't know who of you guys were there, but We were pushing the car down the strip on the first run, but we managed to get it up and running the same day still, so that we can at least get a few pulls in. It wasn't 100%, but I feel like that was just a benchmark to give us that little bit of a push. So yeah, everyone helps on this car, and it really is coming together. All of the close friends stated. But yeah, I'm gonna end the video here. I think we will add a few photos in just so that you guys can see a bit of clarity on the car. We are new to this, so we don't want you guys to judge us on our video quality, the way we're moving around, but this is all part of the journey, I think, and we will get better, and we will just make more power, more cars, more stance cars. We're trying to enter all of them at once, so we'll see. Cape Town has some good stock, so we have a long way to go.
Perfect.
But from our sides,
peace.